Season 2, Episode 18, Peter Bussunnum.
I can do whatever I want. Watch this.
Oh, now you're just being crazy.
Hey, that's against the law. You're coming with me.
Can't touch me. Can't touch me.
I told you, homeboy. Can't touch it.
There is a lot to capture here, so let's break down the lyrics.
Just like the bad guy from Lethal Weapon 2.
Arjun Rudd, a South African diplomat.
I've got diplomatic immunity, so hey mate, you can't sue.
Actually not true. Diplomatic immunity does not cover private or criminal actions unrelated to their diplomatic duties, and immunity could be invoked at any time.
I can write graffiti, even jaywalk in the street. I can riot, loot, not give a hoot, and touch your sister's tea. Can't touch me.
What in God's name is he doing?
Can't touch me.
I believe that's the worm.
Stop. Peter time. I've been around the world from Hartford to Back Bay.
Hartford, Connecticut and Back Bay, Massachusetts are only like a 40-minute flight from one another. So you, not that far, Peter.
It's Peter. Go, Peter. Up to Peter. Yo, Peter. Let's see Regis rap his way. Can't touch me. Except for you. You can touch me.
You can't touch this. Break it down!
I'm Susan Sarandon. A lot of you know me as Tim Robbins' mother, but I'm actually his girlfriend. And this is Stewie.
What the deuce?
For less than the ticket price of one of my movies about capital punishment or neo-feminism, you can make sure that Stewie never goes hungry again.
Hilarious. Susan Sarandon and Tim Robbins were in a relationship from the late 1980s to 2009. They met while filming the movie Bull Durham and became a well-known Hollywood couple despite their 12-year age difference. They couple even had two sons together. Against the backdrop of one of those pandering Sarah McLachlan commercials, this joke just works perfectly in this episode, even if you don't understand the context.
For less than the ticket price of one of my movies about capital punishment or neo-feminism.
As for her movies about capital punishment, MacFarlane has to be referring to Dead Man Walking, great film where she plays a real-life anti-death penalty activist. And fun fact, it's actually directed by Tim Robbins. Then there's one of the greatest feminist movies of our generation, Thelma and Louise.
You can make sure that Stewie never goes hungry again.
Yes, and from the look of those sweater cows, so can you.
Special, like Special K, the cereal. Hey, what did they do with the regular K? And for that matter, whatever happened to K Ballard? You know, if you said mallard and you had a cold, it would sound like ballad.
K Ballard was an American actress, comedian and singer. She gained recognition for her comedic timing and musical abilities, appearing in various entertainment mediums from the 1940s to the 2000s. While she enjoyed a successful career spanning decades, as she grew older, her appearances in major projects became less frequent. All in all, I don't even think Peter knew where he was going with this spiel.
Well, I'm getting something really special too. And by special, I don't mean special like that Kleinerman boy down the street. More special like... Like Special K, the cereal. Hey, what did they do with the regular K? And for that matter, whatever happened to K Ballard? You know, if you said mallard and you had a cold, it would sound like ballad.
Even listen to yourself when you talk.
I drift in and out. I don't pay for drinks. You think G. Gordon Liddy paid for his drinks while he was strangling people with piano wire for the good of our nation?
Yet another Nixon joke. I can only imagine how many Trump jokes we have in store for future Family Guy seasons. G. Gordon Liddy is best known for his involvement in the Watergate scandal during the 1970s. Liddy served as a key member of the White House Plumbers, a cover team tasked with preventing leaks and conducting intelligence activities under President Nixon's administration. Liddy was involved in planning and executing the break-in at the Democratic National Committee headquarters. He was sentenced to prison and served about 4.5 years of his sentence before being released on parole. But there is no evidence of him ever strangling anyone with a piano cord, though I wouldn't put it past him.
I don't pay for drinks. You think G. Gordon Liddy paid for his drinks while he was strangling people with piano wire for the good of our nation?
Attention, delegates. This session of the United Nations is hereby convened.
Man, this sucks. Hey, podium guy! Hey, I got a problem here.
Excuse me, some of us are here to learn.
No one's talking to you, Albanian.
There are so many world leaders represented in this episode, and although this episode aired in the year 2000, MacFarlane used some outdated references.
Attention, delegates.
Here's Kofi Annan, the Ghanaian former Secretary General of the United Nations.
Hey, podium guy. Hey, I got a problem here.
Excuse me, some of us are here to learn.
No one's talking to you, Albania.
Maybe this is Argim Nesho, who was the UN representative for Albania in 2000, though it doesn't look much like him.
Hey, Slobodan, you made it!
Slobodan Milosevic was removed from office by this time and would soon be convicted of war crimes.
I didn't know what to bring, so I made coleslaw.
It's made out of people!
Silent
just kidding.
People!
Hey, is Muammar here yet?
He's referencing Muammar Gaddafi, leader of Libya, who's chatting it up with the infamous Iraqi ruler Saddam Hussein.
And then Jerry guessed that her name was Mulva.
What?
Mulva?
Mulva?
My aunt's name is Mulva.
It really reminds me of me and my friends. You know, the way we just hang out. Before I kill them for worshipping the wrong god.
Yeah, and I love that Kramer guy. He comes in the room like this. But I can't do it. But
in the bathroom. So when she comes out, you introduce yourself, and then she'll be forced to say her name.
10-4.
Okay.
Oh, hello.
Hello, I'm Kramer.
Nice to meet you.
See you later.
Yeah, those are looking good. Yeah, Manuel, can you ask him if he wants cheese?
Manuel Noriega was the military leader of Panama until he was arrested and sentenced in America for a number of crimes.
Fidel, no running around the pool.
Fidel Castro was the longtime leader of Cuba.
They don't respect you.
What do you mean?
Listen to me. I used to be the laughingstock around here until my country invaded Kuwait. Now I have a seat in the third row.
While it's common knowledge Saddam Hussein led Iraq into the Gulf War in 1990 by invading Kuwait, I'm assuming this is one of his minions. The internet says Tariq Aziz, but I just don't see the resemblance.
Wait a second, if everybody respects you, how come you're still eating here by yourself?
I don't shower.
Oh, that's what that is.
What are our options?
Well, a military strike against such a small nation could cause an international backlash.
True, but this kind of behavior can't be tolerated.
Agreed. I suggest we start with political things.
Very good, gentlemen.
We invited Jesse Jackson to open our negotiations with a prayer. Unfortunately, he couldn't make it. So in his place, we have LaToya Jackson.
Thanks. Rub-a-dub-dub. Thanks for the grub. Yay, God!
It's got headphones, so I can watch my Steven Seagal movies without waking Bonnie.
Yes! Rock and load! Rock and load! Bring on the pain!
You bastards come into our village and kill our fish, pollute our water. I'm gonna send you back to hell where you belong.
Hey, wait, come back here!
What?
I have to draw you. You're why cavemen painted on walls.
You're missing the point. Our blockade is turning Pretoria into a third world country.
I'm a born leader, like my great-great-uncle Ulysses S. Griffin.
Chug-a-lug, 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 chug-a-lug.
Yeah! Woo! How's that, Robert E. Lee?
All right, no more slaves. But we still don't have to read books.
Deal.
Yeah! Woo!
Uncle Sam sent me $500.
I got $600.
I got $850.
I got a rock. But unfortunately, you're not entitled to a refund. Mr. Griffin, are you okay?
I'm sorry. I still haven't gotten over the loss of Party of Five. It's going to take some time to get over it. Now, what were you saying?
You're not entitled to a refund.
I'm sorry. Come again?
You're not entitled to a refund. Was that for Party of Five, too?
No, that was for my refund. What the hell's Party of Five?
Okay, we've narrowed it down to two possible names. All in favor of Bugs Bunny? And all in favor of Ephraim the Retarded Rabbit.
Oh, you can all go to hell!
I don't get it. So, like, can the family understand the baby, or what's the deal with that?